LinkedIn Sales Navigator, the mightiest of lead gen tools for any B2B sales team. Find, research, and connect with the perfect buyers. But most users are only using a fraction of its total power. Hey there, my name's Will, and welcome to the long-awaited part two to our LinkedIn Sales Navigator Masterclass. If you haven't already seen the video, that's where we covered some of the fundamentals of using Sales Navigator to build lead lists and account lists and find leads and save them and reach out to them. But in this video, we are gonna go deep.
For a freshwater creature, frogs are really cool.
If this is your first experience with Sales Navigator, this might be a little bit rich for you. Go back and watch that last video and then come back and watch this one. This is some advanced secret shit, all right? Okay, most people don't even do this, all right? So here are the cheekiest ways that I use Sales Navigator. Let's go. Number one, the thing that I mentioned in the last video, Boolean searches. Back in the day when I was a recruiter, I used Boolean searches to scour through resumes and find keywords. And most sellers have no idea how to even do them. And they can be so useful to find leads that you otherwise wouldn't be able to find. I'll show you right now. So in LinkedIn, you get all of these kind of preset search functionalities that you know about right now. And you can use them to both include or exclude certain criteria. However, by using this search functionality, you are confined to the restrictions and the categories and the labels that LinkedIn puts on things. I'll give you an example. For industry, there's no software industries. And what that means is people often label themselves as the wrong industry. So in this case, Jay here is the VP of sales at Ripple Match. That is a recruitment automation platform, a software company. But he's put his industry as human resources because that's who the platform is for. What this means is we're missing all these great leads, and if we try and broaden our search, we might end up with a bunch of noise and leads that aren't a fit, so we waste time looking through them. At this point, you might want to start using keyword searches instead, and what this does is scours the prospects, the person's profile for certain keywords. Right now under this search, we have 27,000 results, and I might just want to put in SaaS. And by doing that, I got my search down to 3,500 results because all of these people are now in this result have the word SaaS somewhere on their LinkedIn profile. But there is no filter for SaaS on the LinkedIn Sales Navigator searches. People tend to call themselves all kinds of funny stuff. Just think about salespeople. You've got account executives, territory managers, sales reps, account managers, key accounts. All of these things mean the same thing. They're a salesperson, but they're calling themselves all different kinds of things, and therefore you might miss them by doing a narrow search like vice president of sales in the filters. So instead, that's where the keyword search comes in. So I'll get rid of that title filter, and instead I'm gonna lengthen the query. So with Boolean searches, you have a few options. The first one, most common one, and. So when you use the and function, it creates a search that's gonna try and find both things you're searching for. So for example, SaaS and sales. And it will only show you results that are true for both of the keywords that you're searching. The next big one is or. It basically says if either of these things are true, then include them in the search. So for this, I could use SaaS or software as a service. They both mean the same thing, but they're written in different ways. I don't want both of them written on the profile. I just need one of them for them to be a match. And the final term is not, a way to exclude certain words or terms. And that means I can start getting rid of some false positives and refining my search further. Let's say we're looking for vice presidents of sales who have the words SaaS or software as a service somewhere on their profile. So the first thing you're gonna do when you wanna do complex kind of queries is start making use of brackets and quotations. Quotations allow you to, instead of searching for one word, search for an entire phrase. I can do quotation, vice president of sales. And now it's gonna only show me people who have that exact phrase as it's written there in those quotations in their profile. We get 42,000 results. We know that vice presidents of sales call themselves other stuff, like VP of sales, right? So I'm gonna actually put a bracket in front of this one. And then I'm gonna put or, and then I'm gonna do VP of sales, close bracket. And that increased the search results to 69,000, right? And now I can start layering other words. So I can do and, open bracket, SaaS, or, and then we can do the software as a service. However, we might not want folks who are like the vice president of business development. So we might want to start excluding people, not business development. We may also want to exclude people who are regional VPs of sales. So we add that in there as well. And slowly we start to whittle down this list until we've got 992 results. And we know all of these people have the words VP or vice president of sales, SaaS, software as a service, but aren't regional and aren't VPs of business development. And that is a superpower for finding leads that no one else in your team and none of your competitors are gonna be able to find. Keyword searching gives you great results. Next, let's get a little bit cheeky up in here. Let's get devious. This field right here, connections of. What this will mean is if I put someone's name in here, I'll just use Tyler Lassard. That means all of these 13 connections meet my search criteria and they are first degree connections of Tyler Lassard. So how can this help you? If you have a competitor who you know doesn't have the best product, or maybe they're lacking a certain feature, or a lot of customers choose to move from them to your company for a certain reason, or maybe they've had some bad press, then you may well want to search for leads who are connected with their sales reps, or better yet, their customer success managers, because that would imply that those leads are a customer of, or were a past customer of, that company. So Kelsey Calabro is a CSM. If I click her in here, I can kind of assume that at least half these people are probably customers of Kelsey's. And therefore I can message them. I'm not gonna say, hey, I know you're customers of this company, but I can highlight the thing that I know my competitor doesn't do well. Maybe they don't have a CRM integration or something like that. I can be like, hey, a lot of companies are struggling to move data from system, thing you sell, to their CRM. How are you currently doing that? We've found our native Salesforce integration helps our customers do that seamlessly. And let's be honest, if let's say Kent here is really annoyed that his current solution doesn't connect with his CRM, that's gonna be a really relevant message and get a really good conversation going immediately. You didn't hear it from me. The only thing you need to know is that if you want this to work, then you need to make sure that you're a first degree connection with the person that you put in this. So go connect with your competitors, sales reps, and their CSMs and start doing searches like this. It's a recession. Dog eat dog. Come on. We got to do what we got to do, folks. Here's one for you. So your company, assuming that you sell for an established company, probably has some customers. So what you might want to do is go into search and add in the past company and include some of those companies that are currently your customers. And then when you couple that with your other search criteria, you're going to find people who used to work at those companies who have now moved on to other companies. Now, depending on when that company became your customer and when these people left that company, there might be some crossover there where these people are either aware of your product or maybe they even used your product. What that means is you can send them a really cheeky message that says something along the lines of, hey, Darren, I know you used to work at, let's say, LinkedIn. LinkedIn are one of our biggest customers here at Vidyard. Not sure if you had a chance to use the platform during your time there. However, I wanted to ask, are you currently using anything like that for sales videos at Scope AR? It's a really warm and relevant message, and chances are Darren is probably quite aware of the product. Let's switch gears a little bit right now. So in sales, we tend to talk to a lot of people, right? And those conversations can sometimes just happen and then we never speak to that person again. Those people that you've spoken to, regardless if they bought or not, now have a relationship with you. Ideally, they'll remember you and they'll probably remember your product as well. You did the work to make that relationship and make that connection. Don't let it go to waste. Instead, whenever you speak to someone, go and add them to a lead list. Create a list called past champions. Whenever you book a meeting with someone or speak to someone or do a demo and they're on the call, add them to this list. Once a month, maybe once every 2 weeks, come into this list and click change jobs in the past 90 days. And now we have four people who know us, who we might have a relationship with, who know about our product, who are now working at different companies. Do you hear that? That sounds like opportunity knocking. If I did a demo with Gabby at her last company, well, now I can reach out to her and say, hey, Gabby, congrats on the move. Have you got anything like, I don't know, sales feed at Slate yet? Warm conversation, waiting to happen. The bigger and longer the list becomes over time, the more valuable it will become to you. All right, so when you're doing a search, you can actually save the search. Why might you want to do that? Well, if you do a really intrinsic search with lots of different like variables and excludes and includes and all that stuff, that's a lot of work and you might not get all the way through the list. Or you might want to come back to that list later and add more criteria to it. So save yourself the time and save the search if you think it's going to be one that you're going to come back to. Now, the second reason is if I do a really specific search, there's only 7 results, but these people might be really, really, really good fits for what I sell. Well, if I save that search, people are always moving jobs, updating their LinkedIn, doing whatever. And what that can mean is they now suddenly fit the criteria for that search. So whilst there were only 7 people before, a couple of months later, there might be 14 more. By saving the search, you can go to your saved searches and see when there's new results within a certain search. And when you click on that new, it will show you all of the people who are new to that search that you might not have looked at before. And therefore you can go through them and see all these new people who fit that perfect persona for you. Go through them, see who's a fit, and add them into your lead list so you then can prospect them. The next hack is actually on people's profile. You'll see a bunch of info, some useful, some not. Karina looks like a good lead and I want a reason or something to mention a message to Karina. What I can do is go through and find what we have in common. We both have all these mutual connections and we both work at Social. So we could have been co-workers, or maybe we just missed each other, but maybe we know a lot of the same people. The next place that you might want to look is getting introduced. So what this does is looks at all the mutual connections that myself and Karina have and show me places where I might be able to get a warm intro to her. Now, the downside to this is that these days on LinkedIn, a lot of people just connect with everyone. So just being a connection isn't really enough to know that they actually knew them. However, if we go into shared work experience, then this will only show me people who are mutual connections of mine and Karina's, who Karina worked at the same company with. So then all of a sudden, if I can see, oh, hang on a second, Karina works or worked with Alexine, who's the CEO at Women in Sales, and they worked there at the same time, and Alexine is an existing customer of mine, I can then either ask Alexine for an intro to Karina, or I can reach out to Karina and say, hey, Karina, my name's Will. I've done a fair bit of work with Alexine over at Women in Sales. We helped them do this, this, and this. I'm curious if you checked something like this out before. Both of those can lead to a very warm conversation. If you're collaborating with colleagues, or maybe you have an SDR or someone else in your team who's working with you, and you want to share a search with them so they don't have to go and do that search themselves, all you have to do is go up to the top of the page while you're making a search and then just copy this across. When you send that link to someone else, when they whack that in there, it will give them the exact same search that you just had. So that's a really easy way to share searches with your colleagues so they can collaborate with you. Okay, next hack. When you look at someone's profile on LinkedIn, let's say Karina right now, the default is that Karina will now get a notification that Will Aitken has viewed her profile. You might not want that. You might be trying to be covert, sneaky. You may just not want Karina to feel like she's being stalked. What you can actually do is go into your settings on Sales Navigator, and you can do this on core LinkedIn as well, and decide how you're viewing people's profile. You can do it in private mode, you can do it in profile characteristics, or you can do it so they can see everything about you and know it was actually you who looked at their profile. My preference, I like to do it in private mode. You know, sometimes I just want to look at someone from my high school and see how much more successful I am than them. I don't want them to know I'm looking at their profile. That's me switching gears again. This is a really good way to get some competitive intel. If you go into past company and type in the name of your competitor, let's say we compete with Salesforce, and then go to the current company and put in your company, let's say we work for HubSpot, then what we're gonna find is a list of people who currently work at our company, HubSpot, but who used to work at Salesforce, HubSpot's competitor. And these people are a goldmine. I can now go and ask Vidya, hey, what are Salesforce really not good at when it comes to this? And what features do Salesforce have on the roadmap in this department? These people can give you all the competitive intel and landmines that you can use while messaging people, while reaching out to people, while doing competitive sales cycles. All right, for the last few hacks, I'm gonna show you some features that aren't actually available in the core plan. They're only available in the advanced and advanced plus plans. Number one, you can share your searches and your lead lists with colleagues on your team. This makes it really easy to collaborate with people, share things with your BDR, your SDR, your account executive, your sales manager, let them have insight into what you're working on. Another massive time saver is the ability to upload CSV lists. So let's say you have a list of key accounts, or you have a list of customers in your CRM, and you want to add those folks as an account list to Sales Navigator. Well, what you can do is upload a list, find my account list, open it up. But once that's done, you now have all of the leads uploaded to Sales Navigator, so you don't have to manually go and add them to your account lists. Now, why would you want to do this? Well, then when you want to go start searching for leads, you can add that account list as one of the criteria, and that way you can actually search for leads within your list of named accounts, key accounts, your existing customers, if you're working expansions and renewals, and you can find all the people who are part of those lists, but also meet your other criteria like vice president of sales, etc. I've got a special treat for all of you beautiful people today. I've got someone from the LinkedIn team who's gonna come in and show one of the latest features that LinkedIn has just launched. It's all about buyer intent.
Buyer intent is one of LinkedIn's newest features. What makes up LinkedIn's buyer intent signals? This is going to indicate any LinkedIn.com activity. So are people viewing profiles, looking at company pages, who their new connections are, posting specific content, reacting to posts. All of that activity is going to play into the score or the signal about buyer intent. Any advertising activity, so if they're engaging with a company's advertisements on LinkedIn, emails or messages that are sent, received, responded to, and even the content within those plays into the score. And then buyer intent activity outside of LinkedIn.com too. So if there's customers who have the LinkedIn Insights tag on their company page. It will include those website visitors as well as some third-party internet signals as well. So there's a lot going into our intent data, and a lot of it is first-party proprietary LinkedIn data. In my opinion, the best professional data set on the planet. And one of the things to point out is that these top secret and brand new buyer intent signals are available for license types advanced online, advanced, and advanced plus. But if you have advanced online, so you're buying the advanced version and you're paying for it yourself, you do have to follow this link to request access and to request this secret to be unlocked within your Sales Nav instance. Let's go through the four areas within Sales Navigator that these buyer intent signals now live. The first is on your homepage, the accounts that you've saved. If you click to filter by those accounts and drop down on the various account level alerts that are available to you, you'll see buyer intent comes up as one that you can isolate. The other is in the accounts tab. You'll start to see a buyer intent dashboard show up. So again, all of the accounts that you've saved will be listed here, and you'll see now a buyer intent score of either high, medium, and low. The third place is on the account pages that exist within SalesNav. So if we go into the Microsoft account as an example, roll down to the intent section, and it's now going to show you that score. It'll tell you month over month if that score's gone up, and then it'll tell you some of the key factors that are affecting that score. And so again, you can see the in-mail acceptance rates, company page engagement or views, and then profile page views of either your own profile or the other executives at Microsoft that a customer might be viewing on LinkedIn. The last spot is within that account filter. In here now you'll see a buyer intent filter come up, and you can select to isolate the accounts that are expressing a moderate or high intent signal with your company. This is the first introduction of our buyer intent signals, but I would expect this to be an area that you see evolve very quickly this year. For our product teams, this is one of the priorities. And so this is only the beginning, but you'll definitely see that these buyer intent signals start to get stronger and more valuable and hopefully help you sell more.
I am so excited to see what they do with that in the future. That is powerful stuff. Use that. If people are looking at your company or looking at your profile, that is a huge buying trigger. That means they know of you. That's a warm conversation just waiting to happen. If you're using the Advanced Plus plan, AKA your team has bought it for you, then you can actually link your CRM, Salesforce, HubSpot, whatever, with Sales Navigator. And what that enables you to do is in the criteria, you can actually exclude or include people who are already in your CRM. If you're only looking for net new leads, then you might want to exclude from your searches anyone who's already in your CRM, and that way you'll only be showing people who you haven't already added to your CRM and your company probably hasn't been in touch with in the past. All right, and the last feature that's only available to Advanced and Advanced Plus plans is the Smart Links. I showed these a little bit on the last video, but I want to show you just a little bit more on these. So a Smart Link essentially allows you to group and add a bunch of resources in one place under one link that you can share with your prospects. And you can upload pretty much any type of file. Upload a video, upload a link to another website, upload a PDF. Once you've uploaded everything you want to that link, you can then copy that link and send it to your prospects. And as long as they're logged into LinkedIn, when they open that link, you will be able to see exactly when they open that link, what they look at, which files and links they look at within that link, and exactly how long they spend looking at it. On a recent webinar that I did about Sales Navigator, I grabbed this link and I sent it in the chat of the webinar, and 85 people opened it. What's more, I can click in here and see that Kevin Johnson watched my Sales Navigator tutorial for 8 hours. What, 8 hours? It seems like a long time. Well, he had it open on his browser for 8 hours. We can see that Ryan opened my Sales Navigator tutorial, but he also looked at my sequence template for 37 seconds, and I can actually see exactly how long Ryan spent on every single page of my document. You could send all manners of things through this, and because it's coming from LinkedIn, the link is a LinkedIn link, people are gonna be much more trustworthy in this than a link they don't recognize. And it notifies you when they open it. You could be sending your proposals through this, you could be sending your videos, your resources, your call recordings, everything you want to share with your customers can be sent through this platform. And as long as the person receiving it has their LinkedIn open, you'll be able to see who opens it, how many people on their team open it, what they look at within the link, and that gives you all the intelligence you need. Ooh, these Sales Navigator videos take a little bit longer than most to make, and it's currently 1 a.m. So if you respect the grind and the hustle and enjoyed this video or got any kind of value from it, then subscribe to our channel. We've got great stuff outside of just Sales Navigator tutorials as well. All right, that's all for today. Have fun navigating those sales. Drop any questions you have below. I'll be sure to answer them and or elaborate on anything I mentioned in this video.